Yo, this is Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Face facts, what up, what up?
What's going on? It's Trip Young, Real Fans Real Talk, back with another vlog. First and foremost, though, make sure you guys are tuned in every Thursday when we go live on BPN2, Verizon 44 throughout the entire New York City, 8 to 9 p.m. Big shout out to Eric Barkley, retired NBA player, St. John's alumni, played overseas for a while. He came and sat down with us this past Thursday, dope interview. Make sure you guys hit up that YouTube channel right now. If you missed the live show, you can check it out, youtube.com/ For the Fans Productions, and click that subscribe button too while you're there. All right, but definitely check out the interview. It's a dope interview. You can also check out that Gene Dale interview right now. Numbers on that one looking crazy right now. So continue to watch, and again, subscribe, share, rate, comment, review, all that other good stuff. But right now, really quick, just finished watching that Anthony Joshua Joseph Parker heavyweight championship fight. Of course, Joshua got the decision, you know, so congratulations to him on that. But, you know, all in all, fight wasn't nothing crazy. You know, I didn't see too much action going on in that fight. But more importantly, though, the lead up for what should be the next fight, that unification title match between Anthony Joshua and, of course, Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder. I'm hoping that they can sign the paperwork and get that fight, you know, locked in for later this year. If not, early next year. I don't want this thing to drag out to a Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao kind of situation where we waiting 5 years for this fight. You know, you guys know Deontay Wilder has been talking about this fight for the longest. He just did an interview on The Breakfast Club, where, you know, he was talking about he wanted to fight Joshua. Anthony Joshua, you know, after the fight, said that he wanted to fight Deontay Wilder. So I'm hoping that now, you know, the two promoting teams can actually get this thing together. But again, it's boxing, politics as usual. So I'm not 100% sure how long this thing will take, but I am hoping this fight will happen. I think this will probably be the biggest boxing fight, I guess, since Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather. But as far as the heavyweight realm goes, this might be the biggest since Tyson Holyfield, this fight here. It's definitely a super fight, definitely a pay-per-view fight. Now, I know what's going to come into play here, two things, location and fight share, the purse split. So what I suggest to both promoters is, you know what, let's do this. Let's be fair, because I can already tell that Anthony Joshua is not trying to come to the United States to fight. And this is something I spoke about before, where, you know, I noticed a lot of the European fighters, they don't come over here to fight a lot of the, you know, the top dogs in their prime, you know, i.e. Joe Calzaghe fought, you know, he didn't come over here to fight B-Hop or Roy Jones when they, you know, in their prime. You know, he had them later on over, you know, overseas. But, you know, it is what it is. So let's do this. Whoever takes the lesser portion of the fight purse, then they get to choose where the fight goes down at. I think that'll be perfect for both parties. So you want to take the biggest split in the fight purse? All right, fine. Whoever gets the smaller split, then they get to pick the fight. So if Deontay takes the smaller share, then the fight goes down over here in the United States. If Joshua is down to take the smaller split, then let's have the fight over in the UK. I think that makes it kind of, you know, evens things out for both fighters. I know it's going to be a lot of give and take. I am hoping that they can actually take my advice, though, on this one. Because, again, just from watching that, you know, that after the press conference, after in the ring with Joshua, he's not sounding like he's trying to come to the U.S. to fight Deontay Wilder. I'm not going to say he's scared, but I would say he's smart. You know, I don't think that he wants any smoke with Deontay Wilder in the United States. I think he feels more comfortable fighting in the UK. He probably feels like he has the advantage fighting over there. Personally, I feel like Deontay Wilder will win that fight, whether it's in the United States or whether it's in the UK. So I don't think that that really matters for Deontay Wilder. But I really feel like Joshua will not come to the United States for this fight. And if that's the hang-up, the fight won't happen because he won't come to the United States to make this fight. It's more likely that Deontay will go over to the UK to fight just because, he, you know, I think he wants this fight a lot more than Joshua. I mean, flat out, Deontay Wilder has the best hands in boxing right now. His right hand is something crazy. And, you know, by the looks of this fight with Parker, it's going to be a whole nother ball game for Joshua. So if the fight actually does happen, I'm taking Deontay Wilder by knockout. I know he really wants that knockout, so I'm going Deontay Wilder by knockout. Hoping, as a boxing fan, you guys know on the show we're big boxing fans. We're affiliated with Ranks in New York, which is a boxing charity right here out of the Bronx. Shout out to all of those guys, Matt Farrago, Mr. B, Johnny Z, all of the Rankton family, Iran Barkley, you know, everybody over there. We're big boxing fans, so I really want to see this thing happen. And, of course, the great Mark Breland out of Brooklyn, welterweight champion, Golden Gloves champ, Olympic gold medalist, who's also a friend of Real Fans Real Talk, and, you know, one of Deontay's trainers. Shout out to him and JD's. They showed us a lot of love when we went down to Alabama to interview Deontay Wilder a couple of years ago. So, of course, yes, we're rooting for the home team. You know, Deontay Wilder leads off the show for us every Thursday, heavyweight champion of the world. You watching Real Fans Real Talk. So, again, let's make the fight happen. Treat the fans. Don't cheat the fans. Wilder versus Joshua. Let's get it. 2018. Let's start that campaign. Hashtag Wilder versus Joshua. Let's get it. That's a wrap, guys. Trip Young for Real Fans Real Talk. Again, make sure you guys tune in every Thursday night when we go live, 8 to 9 p.m. Verizon 44 throughout the entire New York City on BPN2. If not, you guys can check it out on the web, realfansrealtalk.com. And make sure you guys are following us on all our social media, facebook.com/realfansrealtalk, Instagram and Twitter at realfantalk. And if you guys have fan mail questions for us, send them in, fanmail@realfansrealtalk.com. And of course, make sure you guys subscribe to that YouTube channel, youtube.com/footerfansproductions. With that being said, I'm up out of here.
It's realtalk.com with Arthur Domus, Trip Young, and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan, I get all my facts from my bro Mark the Stats, man.